The last 3 decades have been in focus because of information and communication technology. A lot of things have been happening, very exciting things. But at the same time, something equally exciting that is happening has not actually caught media attention. And that is the development in human sciences. Starting with the early 1980s, when Howard Gardner propounded the theory of multiple intelligence, he said that there is no linear IQ which everybody used to believe in at that time. It's not that the fellow who can memorize and who can calculate fastest, he is going to be successful in everything. There are so many different types of intelligences. You can have creative intelligence, you can have interpersonal intelligence, you can have intrapersonal intelligence. All these things opened new doors to thinking about human behavior. Just a decade later, Daniel Goleman came up with the concept of emotional intelligence. And he said that the IQ is going to play hardly a 20% role in a person's development or success or happiness. Compared to that, 80% of your success, fulfillment, happiness, achievement will depend on your EQ, which is the emotional quotient. Emotional quotient in very simple terms is managing yourself, your emotions, understanding your emotions, finding out what motivates you, and being able to empathize with others, deal with others. Sounds very simple, no? It isn't. It's something that has to be taught at a very deep level. By the time that was happening, before Y2K came, we got this wonderful report from WHO, the World Health Organization, which listed out 10 most important and very basic life skills. WHO did an extensive global survey and came up with these 10 life skills and said, if you really want to lead a good quality of life, be in harmony with others, be at peace within yourself, you need to master these 10 life skills. So starting with multiple intelligences, going on to emotional quotient, going on to life skills. Within a span of 20 years, the entire outlook towards life and human beings changed. That is why you are very lucky to be in this world, in this beginning of the 21st century. Because today you have the wherewithal, you have the means, you have the expertise, you have the training how to lead a good life. If we can all sharpen our life skills and in turn teach these life skills to the younger generation, believe me, we'll be doing wonders, not only to them, but even to our own selves. Because remember that as we grow older and as we become more and more dependent on the younger generation, unless we have taught them basic life skills and how to deal with the world, how to deal with the senior citizens and the elderly and the infirm, the world is not going to be a good place to lead the rest of your life. That is our humble mission, and I welcome you into this.
Classes are always carried out in a very informal and warm atmosphere, as you can see here. Everyone is allowed to give his or her viewpoint. Doubts are clarified there and then. And at the same time, firm moderation ensures that the right learning becomes your takeaway after every session. Of course, there's a lot of humor too, but don't tell anyone right now.
One part of this course is about learning life skills for yourself. The other part is how do you teach it to others? So that's another important part of this course. So we are going to train the trainer program where we not only teach you the life skills, we also train you how to teach it to others. And here the presentation skills become the key part of this course. So the entire focus of this course when it comes to assessment is on presentation skills. How good are you at presenting yourself in front of others? For this, what we have done is, we have many people would say that they are not really confident of going in front of others and talking about the course, about the content of the course to them. So what we are doing is, we are giving you a graded presentation. For instance, you will start off with just a 2-minute presentation of all about yourself. Then what we do is, we give you a 5-minute presentation. You say, come and speak for 5 minutes on any topic of your choice. But then include a story element in it. Why story? Because children are always attracted to story. We learn when we listen to stories, we learn it much better. We remember things much better when we listen to stories. So we said, can you include stories? So you will inculcate the idea of including stories in your presentation when you present it. Then the third time we said, come and present for 10 minutes on a topic, which we will give, a life skill topic, but can you include humor? Again, when you look at it, some of the best presenters are people who have got a great sense of humor. You know, when you actually make the audience laugh, they connect you very well. So how do you do that? Can you really practice including humor in your presentation? That's what we are going to train you here. Can you include humor? And then there will be another session on how do you include the audience in your presentation. I mean, on one hand, you can come here for a 45-minute session and talk about the life skills or whatever you want for 45 minutes to 1 hour, you can give a lecture. It can become boring provided you're the only person talking about it. But on the other hand, suppose you're able to include the audience in your presentation, the whole class becomes much more lively. Everybody feels that they are also participating in it. So how do you include an audience in your presentation? Can you, for instance, give an activity to the participants? Can you include a group discussion with the participants? Or can you ask them to raise questions in your session? This is the way where the session goes from 5 minutes up to 20 minutes. We'll start off with 3 minutes on yourself, and by the time you finish the course, you would have done a 20-minute presentation on your own. Now that really is where you're building the confidence for you. And that is the train-the-trainer part of this program. I really look forward to having you in this.
Students who come in to learn life skills, and we see them, we watch them go out to schools, colleges to train youngsters, not necessarily school children, college children, but the basic skills that are necessary to lead a balanced life. I won't even say happy life, I will say balanced life, because challenges are going to be there in life, but these children are balanced. We are trying to equip and empower children with life skills which are necessary to lead a balanced life. When we look at our students go out there and teach these children basic skills like how do you make a decision? What career do I choose, or what chocolate do I eat, or what ice cream, which flavor of ice cream do I eat, is sometimes a very big decision somebody has to make. Starting from eating an ice cream to choosing a life partner, there are so many decisions that these children have to make. I'm just talking about one life skill, but there are so many choices that these children have from where they have to make a decision. And all this we see year after year, our students going out there and teaching them in such fun, activity-based methods. The children just lap up the concept of what it means to make a decision. And that, I think, is what we are doing in terms of a human service, saying children need that. It is because, unlike the earlier years, children are with small families, so they need to learn these life skills by an external faculty or resource person, because they are living in challenging times, huge competitive world out there. So this is what we are going to equip them when we teach them life skills. And believe us, we have seen, when we say we have trained children and youth, the amount of empowerment that they have is sometimes remarkable, because years later, after they have done our training program, when our students have gone and taught children these life skills, they come back and say, what you taught us that day made a difference in my life. That, I think, is the power of life skills.
Perfect.